Captain Abraham Lincoln and the Indian. Among the rough young men of the frontier, Abraham Lincoln was famous for his quick wit and great strength. Many stories are told of his courage in rescuing the weak and helpless from danger, often at the risk of his life. When Lincoln was serving as captain in the Black Hawk War, there wandered into his camp one day a poor old Indian. The Indian carried no weapon, and he was too old to be dangerous. He was just a forlorn, hungry old man in search of food. Injun white man's friend. He cried to the soldiers, as he took a paper from his belt and held it out to them. The paper was a pass from the general in command, saying that the old man was a peaceful, friendly Indian. But the soldiers were too much excited to pay any attention to the pass. "Kill him! Scalp him! Shoot him!" they cried, running for their weapons. They were enlisted to fight Indians, and here was an Indian, perhaps Black Hawk himself. They were not going to let him escape. "Me good Injun. Big white chief says so, see talking paper," protested the Indian, again offering him the paper. "Get out. You can't play that game on us. You're a spy. Shoot him. Shoot him," the soldiers shouted. A dozen men leveled their rifles ready to fire. The others handled the old Indian so roughly and made so much noise over the prize that they aroused the captain. "What is all the trouble about?" he demanded, coming from his tent. His glance fell on the frightened Indian, cowering on the ground. Dashing in among his men, he threw up their weapons, and shouted, "Halt! Hold on, don't fire! Stop, I tell you!" Then, placing his hand on the red man's shoulder, he cried, "Stand back, all of you. You ought to be ashamed of yourselves, pitching into a poor old redskin. What are you thinking of? Would you kill an unarmed man?" "He's a spy. He's a spy," shouted the soldiers. "If he's a spy," answered Lincoln, "we will prove it, and he shall suffer the penalty. Until then, any man who harms him will have to answer to me." The poor old Indian crouched at Lincoln's feet, recognizing in him his only friend. "What are you afraid of?" demanded one of the ringleaders, raising his rifle. "We're not afraid to shoot him, even if you are a coward." The tall young captain faced his accuser and slowly began to roll up his sleeves. "Who says I'm a coward?" he demanded. There was no response to this. Every man in the company knew the great strength of that brawny arm. Some had felt it on more than one occasion. "Get out, captain," they said. "That's not fair. You're bigger and stronger than we are. Give us a show." "I'll give you all the show you want, boys," Captain Lincoln replied. "More than you are willing to give this Indian. Take it out of me, if you can. But you shall not touch him." Again, there was no answer. The Indian showed his pass, which proved him to be one of the friendly Indians from General Cass' division. Lincoln knew at once that it was genuine. The young captain ordered one of the men to give the captive food and let him go free. The poor man could not speak his thanks. To show his gratitude, he knelt down and kissed the feet of the young soldier. The men scattered and the trouble was over. No man in that camp had any desire to try his strength with Captain Abraham Lincoln, who was ready to protect a friendless Indian with his life.